माय सेल्फ दर्शना मोरे, असिस्टंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ फ्रूट सायन्स, के केवा कॉलेज ऑफ हॉर्टिकल्चर, नासिक. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अनादर टॉपिक, कल्टिवेशन ऑफ कोकोनट. इन द कल्टिवेशन ऑफ कोकोनट वी विल सी द बोटेनिकल क्लासिफिकेशन, वराइटीज, प्लांटिंग, देन फर्टिलाइजर्स, हार्वेस्टिंग, प्रोसेसिंग एक्सेट्रा. सो द फर्स्ट इज बोटेनिकल नेम ऑफ कोकोनट इज कोकस नुसिफेरा. अंडर द फैमिली ऑफ पाल्मेसी और अरेकासी. क्रोमोसोम नंबर ऑफ कोकोनट इज 2n = 32. ओरिजिन साउथ ईस्ट एशिया एंड इंडोनेशिया एंड मलेशिया. द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ कोकोनट इन द वर्ल्ड इज इंडोनेशिया, फिलीपींस, इंडिया, श्रीलंका, थाईलैंड, मलेशिया एट्सेट्रा. एरिया एंड प्रोडक्शन ऑफ कोकोनट. केरला स्टैंड फर्स्ट इन एरिया एंड प्रोडक्शन, वाइल द प्रोडक्टिविटी इज हाइएस्ट इन आंध्र प्रदेश. द कंपोजिशन ऑफ कोकोनट. फ्रेश कोकोनट इज वाटर 45%, प्रोटीन 4%, फैट 37%, मिनरल इज अबाउट 4% एंड 10% ऑफ कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स इन कोकोनट, फ्रेश कोकोनट. पिक्चर्स ऑफ कोकोनट पाम विथ फ्रूटिंग और विदाउट फ्रूटिंग. नेक्स्ट वी विल सी द जनरल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ कोकोनट इज द आउटर मोस्ट कवर ऑफ कोकोनट इज आउटर कवर. देन सेकेंड लेयर ऑफ कोकोनट इज कोइर और मिडल फाइबरस कोट ऑफ फ्रूट्स. थर्ड लेयर इज शेल और इनर हार्ड कोट ऑफ फ्रूट्स. फोर्थ इज द सीड एंड फिफ्थ नंबर ऑफ लेयर इज लिक्विड मिल्क, सॉरी कोकोनट मिल्क और लिक्विड एंडोस्पर्म. एंड इनर मोस्ट लेयर ऑफ कोकोनट इज द वाइट फ्लैश सॉलिड एंडोस्पर्म. दिस इज द जनरल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ कोकोनट. देन जनरल इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट द कोकोनट इज कोकोनट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज कल्पवृक्ष. इट इज द बिगेस्ट सीड कंपेयर टू द अदर फ्रूट क्रॉप्स. इन इंडिया कमर्शियली कोकोनट इज अ कल्टिवेटेड. द मेजर प्रोड्यूसिंग स्टेट्स इन इंडिया इज केरल, कर्नाटक, तमिलनाडु, आंध्र प्रदेश. केरला अकाउंट 54.7% ऑफ टोटल एरिया एंड 42.3% ऑफ प्रोडक्शन, फॉलोड बाय तमिलनाडु एंड कर्नाटका. द मैक्सिमम प्रोडक्टिविटी इज बीइंग 20,621 नट्स पर हेक्टर फ्रॉम महाराष्ट्र. देन यूजेस ऑफ कोकोनट इज इट इज द सीड प्रोवाइड ऑयल फॉर फ्राइंग एंड कुकिंग. द व्हाइट फ्लैश पार्ट्स ऑफ द सीड, द कोकोनट मीट इज यूज फॉर फ्रेश एंड ड्राइंग इन कुकिंग. द ड्राइड कोकोनट इज ऑल्सो यूज एज अ फिलिंग फॉर मिनी चॉकलेट बार्स. द वॉटर कंटेंट ऑफ कोकोनट इज 45 कैलोरीज, 1.3 ग्राम्स ऑफ शुगर एंड 61 मिलीग्राम्स ऑफ पोटेशियम. इन द कोकोनट वाटर हैज अ लेस शुगर दैन मेनी स्पोर्ट ड्रिंक्स एंड मच लेस शुगर दैन सम ऑफ द फ्रूट जूसेस. फ्रॉम द कोकोनट वी कैन ऑल्सो द सम प्रोसेसिंग प्रोडक्ट्स फॉर एंड ऑल्सो यूज फॉर द प्रिपरेशन ऑफ कैडबरीज, चॉकलेट्स, ब्रूम्स, बर्फी, हेयर ऑयल and also used for the preparing kathe. Then soil and requirement for the coconut is coconut require sandy to lateritic, red alluvial, sandy alluvial, coastal, black soil, and lateritic soils are good for its cultivation of coconut. Then the soil pH is predominantly acidic, 4.5 to 6.8. Deep, well-drained and rich in high organic matter content is suitable for the coconut cultivation. Then hard rock soil, then shallow soils are unsuitable for coconut cultivation. Mostly eastern and western belts of India is predominantly soil or coconut is extensively cultivated. Then climatic requirement for the coconut cultivation. It is a tropical plant growing in a tropical climate. Then require warm to humid climatic condition. The annual temperature is about 27 degrees Celsius with 5 to 7 degrees Celsius diurnal variation. The altitude is 600 above the from the mean sea level. Then rainfall 800 to 2500 mm. The humidity should be 80 to 90% and the relative humidity below 50% affects the opening of stomatum. Then coconut palm is a sun loving plant, or sunshine hours per year is about 2000 hours. Then varieties of coconut. In a coconut there are two types of varieties, some of the tall varieties and some of the dwarf varieties. The tall varieties of coconut are mostly commonly cultivated. The height of is about 25 to 30 meter. The bearing start after planting 6 to 10 years. The medium to large size of nuts in a tall palms mature in 12 months after inflorescence of opening of flowers. Then varieties of coconut is West Coast Tall, Bonavali, East Coast Tall, Andaman Ordinary, Kalpashri and Philippines Ordinary. Next one is the dwarf varieties of coconut. It is the dwarf saturated plants. Then bearing start after 3 to 4 years of planting. Then they are identified by color of fruits orange, yellow, red and grey. Under the dwarf varieties, first is the Chougath green dwarf, Chougath orange dwarf, Ganga Bondan in Andhra Pradesh. In Gujarat, mostly Gunanjali dwarf is cultivated and Malayan yellow dwarf. Next we will see the pictures of varieties. Andaman ordinary tall varieties, West Coast tall varieties, then Kalpashri and Philippines ordinary. Then some of the dwarf varieties, green Chougath green, orange and yellow dwarf variety, dwarf coconut. After that, some of the hybrids are also available in coconut. The first Anand Ganga, then Chandrakalpa, Chandralaksha, Kera Ganga, Laksha Ganga, Pratap and VHC1. So the Anand Ganga mostly recommended for the Kerala region. It contains about 68% of oil and 95 nuts per palm per year. Then Chandrakalpa and Chandralaksha mostly recommended for the Kerala and Tamil Nadu region and also in Karnataka region. In Maharashtra, mostly Pratap variety is recommended for the coastal Maharashtra. It contains about 60% of oil and 151 nuts per palm per year. Then after the harvest varieties, hybrid varieties, we will see the propagation of coconut. So the first coconut is mainly propagated through seedlings. In India, generally 9 to 12 month old seedlings are transplanted. These are the pictures of seedling, coconut seedling. For the propagation, mostly selection of mother palm is very important. So the for selection of mother palm, age of the palm, it should attain the age of at least 20 years and not above 60 years of age. Selected palms which have attained full bearing stage and have a high giving regular high yields for at least 4 years. So the age of the plants for the mother palm selection is between 20 to 60 years. And it should be high yielder and early bearing. Then the nuts not less than 100 per palm per year and not less than 150 of copra content per nuts. That is, nut weight is about 1.20 gram on husk and 60 kg for husk palms. Then the shape of the crown, the nature and disposition of leaves on the crowns in coconut, number of total number of fronds on the crown should be more than 30 and generally crown shape. Crown shape is a spherical, that is umbrella shape, drooping or erectile. So the shape of crown is also important for the selection of mother palm. A mother palm should have at least 30 fully open leaves having leaf orientation in all direction, umbrella shape fronds. The nature and number of or the sequence of production of inflorescence. Every leaf axil should have one inflorescence with large number of spikes. Nearly 30 to 35 spikes per inflorescence is required, and one or two female flowers per palm. At any time, there should be 12 bunches with nuts at a different stage of development. Then the size and shape of nuts. Fully dried, unhusked nuts should weigh more than 1.20 kg, and unhusked or the husk nuts should be more than 60 gram, and copra content 150 gram and above. So the weight, size, weight and shape of nut is also important. Then nuts are of round and oblong shape are better for selection. Then palms producing barren nuts or those shedding large number of immature nuts should be discarded. Then planting. The planting of coconut mostly in the onset of monsoon. Keep the field wheeled free. The land preparation for the field planting depends upon the topography, soil type and water table. The recommended spacing of coconut is 7.5 by 7.5 meter for the square system of planting, and also up to the 9 meter is ideal for the tall varieties, and accommodating about 175 of plants if the plant spacing is 7.5 meter, and 124 of plants accommodate per hectare if the distance is 9 meter. Then triangular system of spacing is also used for the coconut plantation. The spacing for a triangular system is 9 meter. It's accommodate about 140 of palms per year. The dimension of peat or the peat size is 1 meter cube are prepared during the summer months. The peats are filled up to 0.25 to 0.30 meter depth with mixture of soil, sand and wood ash before the 1 month of planting. Then the seedlings are planted in the center of the peats. The planting season varies from place to place. Most appropriate time of planting is during in the beginning of monsoon period, May, June and October, November. The regular irrigation should be given during the summer season. These are the pictures of coconut planting, watering and nursery stage of palms. After planting, the manures and fertilizers is also essential for the coconut cultivation or the growth and production of coconut. So the first year of planting, the dose of NPK or the fertilizers is 50, 40 and 122, 135 gram of nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium per pump per tier in a September. The manures, the fertilizers are applied in a two equal split doses, first in the May, June and second in the September, October. The second dose of fertilizer is recommended for the coconut cultivation is 50, 40, 135 gram of NPK in May, June, and second is the 110, 80, 270 gram of NPK. For the dose of fertilizer is increases up to the fourth year after the fourth year of planting. For the fourth year of planting, 170, 120 and 400 of NPK per palm per year in May, June, and second dose 330, 200 and 800 gram NPK per palm per year in September and also onwards. Then the harvesting of coconut. Coconut ripens in 12 to 13 months from the opening of inflorescence. After opening of inflorescence, the fruits or the nuts are mature 12 to 13 months. Then harvesting is done at 45 days of interval during summer and 60 days of interval in rainy season. To get the maximum yield of copra and oil, only fully mature nuts should be harvested. For the getting high yield, only fully mature nuts are harvested. Then maturity indices of coconut is, it should the superior golden brown in color. Then quality of fiber with elastic and tungsten strength is obtained from 10 month of old nuts. The harvested nuts are stored in a heaps under shade for a few days, since the store nuts are easy to husk. Then moisture content of meat is decreases. This is the maturity indices and maturity time, maturity interval, and harvesting of coconut. So the coconut can be harvested by the manually, or also the some mechanical harvester is also available in other countries. So the for the harvesting of coconut, mechanical harvester is useful, but it is very costly. Then yield of coconut. The yield of coconut is depending upon the soil, climate, and varieties. The annual average yield of coconut is 44 nuts per palm per year. Then under the scientific cultivation is 80 nuts per palm per year in coastal Kerala and Karnataka region. Then hybrid varieties produces more yield, 100 to 140 of nuts per palm per year. Then to get the maximum copra and oil, only fully mature nuts should be harvested. Then immature nuts provide 6 to 33% and 5 to 33% of less copra and oil respect. So the fully mature nuts should be harvested. After the harvesting, some processing is also done in coconut. Post harvest processing. In a traditional coconut producing states of India, the post harvest processing is presently confined to the production of edible and milling quality copra, account oil, and coir or coir based products. So the processing of copra, there are two types of processing. First is edible copra and second one is the milling copra. So the after harvesting, optimum moisture content in the copra is 5 to 6% through the sun drying, smoke drying, clean drying, or indirect hot air drying are commonly used methods for drying of coconut. In edible copra, there are two types, ball copra and cup copra. So the first is ball copra. It is produced by storing fully mature unhusked nuts for 8 to 12 months on raised platform, usually made of bamboos. As the water is eventually dried out, the nuts are dehusked and shell broken carefully to remove the copra from inside in the ball form. So the for getting ball copra, the nuts should be dried for 8 to 12 months. The water eventually decreases or dried. They are dehusked and shell broken carefully to remove the whole ball copra from inside. Then second one is the cup copra. For the preparation of cup copra, fully mature nuts are stored for long period, and the cup copra mostly used for the household edible preparation in North India, mostly in used for the household purpose. The seed, the selected nuts are dehusked, cut into cups, and dry under the open sun. That means after the storing in the storing for long periods, the nuts are dehusked and cut into cups. that means cut in half and dried in the under the sun, open sun. Then cups are used for the household edible preparation in northern India. Then next processing is milling copra. In most popular southern states, Kerala, in Kerala, 60 to 65% of the total coconut produce is converted into milling copra. It is made by sun drying through the often is combined with kiln drying during in the monsoon period. Mostly in Kerala, the milling copra is or the coconut is cultivated for the preparing desiccated coconut. So the desiccated coconut is prepared with the small scale unit mainly in Karnataka. It is a partially defatted product yielding superior quality coconut oil also. So this is the process of milling copra. Thank you.